Hello guys, Satnam, welcome to my channel, Puru Puru. This is going to be a pick a card reading to see everything you need to know about your powers. Okay, because we're entering into that space more and more by the second, okay? We're no longer playing spirituality, we are now utilizing actual abilities and powers, okay? And we need to know what's up with that. Ooh. Okay, so we have four piles to pick from as usual. I'm very excited. For pile number one, so I feel like everybody should get excited. We have this beautiful crystal skull, okay? This is carnelian. Look at this. There's like this small fairy vibe inside there. Like, oh, it's just like so cool. Look at that, okay? For pile number one. For pile number two, we have this very cool citrine stone. I wonder, I'm not sure whether this was amethyst or heated. Like, apparently if it has like a coloration like this, it is. But like the guy said that this is like real citrine from like somewhere in Africa, okay? And I think it is. Especially this part, it like looks so real, okay? This specific stone went through a lot of like telekinetic experiences with me. Well, a lot, like two, but it was like a lot as in the yin and the yang in regards to telekinesis. Like, I don't know if that might mean something to you. For pile number three, we have this beautiful piece of spakboom. Ooh, this is my favorite plant, okay? Favorite. You can literally take this and just put it in the ground and it'll grow. Just not in snow. I'm a poet and I know it, okay? Fucking love this plant, you see. And then for pile number four, we have this beautiful wand. Ooh. Even though, like, people would think you would use this wand like this, because, like, the ball in the hand or whatever, and then you direct it. I mean, you can if you want to use it like that. But if you use it like this, as the chakras are even pointing out, like, it has such a broader spectrum of energy, okay? Crystal wand, ooh. Okay, so those are the full piles to see everything you need to know about your powers. Pick your pile and I will see you there. So let's do 0310. Yes, indeed. Ooh. Satnam, pile number one. You know, when I wrote down the timestamp, I just said got a fright, but no. I immediately got this energy of, like, instead of me writing down your timestamp, I had a magic quill doing it for me, okay? So there's something about... I'm also being drawn to that, like, TikTok game about the, like, floating skull where you play this virtual wizard and there's this floating skull. I feel like you're about to... Something in regards to, like, your powers are really about to help you in a very tangible way, okay? Some of you charging up a servitor, whether you know this or not. A servitor is like a consciousness that you create, an energy form that you create to do some kind of purpose for you, to such an extent that the servitor is going to be starting to do tasks like this for you, okay? For some of you, a servitor consciousness or energy is about to actually manifest as a person for you, but it's not really a person. It's like literally this, like, magical experience, okay? That's very cool. So you're about to have some kind of, like, worker, or you're about to have some kind of servitor, okay? Very physical, not just a spiritual or energetic thing. Let's see what's happening for pile number one. I also feel like this consciousness is gonna be not just serving you, but it's going to be charging you in some way. 4, 5, 6. It's going to be giving back in some way. I feel like it has been giving back to you already, okay? But it's going to become much more of a physical thing than just an energetic thing. I'm getting some kind of like symbiotic energy here as well. Okay, because a servitor only exists because you want it to exist, no matter how powerful it becomes or something like that. Okay, I feel like you need to recognize that as well. Okay, let's see. The Queen of Pentacles. Yes, exactly. I feel like you're about to be this Queen of Pentacles and like you're about to have some kind of worker. You're about to have some kind of servitor doing things for you very tangibly. You might have created some kind of servitor with a specific intent, like, and you, it might have been bringing you some like money, or it might have been assisting you in alchemizing certain situations into beauty or like abundance or something. Somebody just skipped to pile number four. Okay, I felt that energy go, but I feel like this is becoming, again, much more tangible. I'm seeing some kind of, like, golem-like or troll-like, like Dobby from Harry Potter, like, esque kind of energy. Like, something is about to fully manifest in your reality, the servitor. Because I feel like your powers are becoming very fine-tuned to such an extent where you can literally nitpick at the atoms of creation, okay? This might be what the servitor has been assisting you with as well, okay? Either you're at the finish point of this journey, or this is the journey you're about to go on, okay? And you're gonna end up like literally materializing like a being that's meant to serve you or something, okay? That you create. Anyway, let's take a sip of coffee first. Knight of Swords, okay? The Sun, okay? And the Nine of Swords. Interesting. The High Priestess, Seven of Pentacles, and the Six of Pentacles. This Nine of Swords energy is actually giving me, like, again, like, a servitor is a thought form that you create. Like, you created, it might have been, this thought form might have been feeding even off of your anxiety or fears or disbelief. Okay, or you're going to be creating this thought form that's going to literally live off of your disbelief. Not in a sense that it's going to keep creating that, but like it's going to take it and alchemize it into sun energy for you. Or this is what you've done and now you get to create the servitor or something like that. Either way, again with the sun as well, like you're literally about to birth something physical. Like you're about to birth a physical being. And I don't feel like you're pregnant. I don't feel like you are anything like that, but you're about to materialize a young being into existence, okay? This skull also reminds me quite a lot of like Adam energy, or the energy of the first human, or like it kind of like resonates to me at the like base of human existence, okay? Like our evolutionary progress process, our core blueprint from a spiritual and physical perspective, etc., etc., okay? So I feel like you're not birthing a new human or creating a new human or coming into new human consciousness or anything. I feel like either you're already there or you're about to finish that process. But I feel like the servitor, the servant you're creating is gonna like, I don't know. It's kind of like having a not a sidekick, but like a personal butler, okay? Like the closest I can relate that to is like, I don't know, like being like, I wanted to say Batman with what's the old man's name? I can't believe I forgot his name. Alfred, right? But like something like that, okay? But in a much more high vibrational magical sense here, especially with the sun energy, okay? And the High Priestess. Or like being Zeus and with his cupbearer Ganymede or something like that, okay? However it is that like you are experiencing this consciousness in your simulation, that's what's about to happen, okay? You're about to materialize a being. And I feel like, again, yeah, Four of Wands, you don't have to keep feeding it or something. The moon, you don't have to keep feeding it, or it's not going to keep you stuck in order to flourish off of your negativity, okay? Like, that's not how it works. Like, it serves you, like, fully, like a house elf or something. I feel like this feels somewhat familiar. I feel like I have shared something like this before, especially on this channel. So maybe go again to pile number four, because I just felt another energy there. But like, there's something about you. It's kind of like you don't, like, if you want not that power or ability, and you rather want the ability to make it rain or move things with your mind or something, I feel like you should tell this consciousness that you've been creating or something or working with that's materializing very fully to kind of remove blockages within you that aren't allowing you that ability. You understand? Like, it's like it can do even that, okay? Okay, thank you so much, pile number one. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting for a personal reading. Okay, everything is in the description box. I'm like, bye. Let's do 11. I'm gonna do 33. 33. Ek dink so, want dan het ons lekker tyd. Nou is tot is 96. Satnam, pile number 2, for those of you who picked this citrine stone. I'm hearing, you know what, it doesn't even matter. This is going to be your reading. It doesn't even matter if it is like heated amethyst, because it's this experience of, like, even if it was heated, like, natural citrine is heated by the earth, whereas this was heated by man. But, like, we then mastered this process of being able to heat it ourselves and create citrine ourselves, okay? So I feel like there's something that you need to know about your abilities, about your powers. Pile number 2 is, I feel like there's some kind of creation happening. But, like, I feel like this creation, it's creation through alchemy, okay? Like, maybe you've learned a lot. Maybe you've, maybe you've learned a lot, or maybe you've mastered a lot of processes that's enabling you to create through alchemy. And for some reason, I feel like there's a difference between creation and creation through alchemy. But, like, creating something from nothing, which I would say is creation, is also alchemy. And citrine is connected to the sun. So there's something about like alchemizing via light or via flame or awareness or something. It's maybe even this ability to alchemize in a divine way through human means, or to alchemize death into life, or, you know, shit like that. There's something very strong here about alchemy for you. Let's see, for pile number 2. And 1133. 33 is a very creator-esque energy, okay? Page of Wands, okay. That's like, that is like learning still, like learning alchemy. But it's kind of giving the sense of the learning is the mastering, okay? Obviously. But it's kind of like you need to see it that way as well. Like, the learning process is the mastery of the alchemy. So what are you creating? Maybe you're creating, you know what, I'm getting even like you have some kind of ability specifically to keep finding ways to alchemize. You might be somebody that's like gonna discover a new element one day, or you're gonna, I don't know, like, create, and I don't know, like, you're, like, it's kind of like alchemizing, not learning through learning, but, like, mastering through learning, like, immediately or something. So maybe you are at your core a master alchemizer, period, point blank, okay? And maybe the recognition of that, like, will kind of push you through some kind of threshold of even more alchemy power. Even alchemizing impossibility into possibility. That's what I want to say. You have an ability to alchemize impossibility into possibility. And I feel like there's a lot again to do with these like steps. Like, you know that like you being able to build a house means you can control your reality. Okay, so now you built a house. Now you think, okay, so I can control my reality on that level. What next level can I control my reality? Then you start saying, oh, I can move things with my mind, or I can do this, or I can do that, etc., etc., etc. I feel like you're about to go through this threshold of mastered alchemy. Even utilizing inertia of an object to create ersha, you know, to create movement, like the immovable, using the immovable to move itself or something like that. Okay, let's continue. Ten of Pentacles, interesting. Ooh. And Citrine is also a lot to do with abundance, of course, you know. It's known as the merchant stone, but I feel like Citrine, like the merchant, I would say is much more to do with like a jack of all trades. Hey, lost my fist. Come, Rommel, go. Lay, Rommel. This jack of all trades energy is giving me this ability to literally utilize any and every frequency in order to create, okay? And not anybody can do that. Not everybody can do that. I think I did a reading yesterday in the collective where I said something about you have to be divine in order to have alchemized this energy. I feel like that's you, okay? And like this Ten of Pentacles is not just physical abundance. It is spiritual abundance. It is magical abundance. It is like, I wouldn't like either you're still the magician in training, or you're about to realize like you are the magician. You understand? Like, I wouldn't be surprised if the magician card actually shows itself here, like truly, because of your alchemizing ability. And there is maybe something different. Like, I feel like there are some beings that can even, like, create, that can't alchemize the way you do or something. Okay? And maybe, again, the only reason you can alchemize the way you do is because you've mastered every process. The process of non-alchemy and the process of, like, pressure, or the process of fire, or, like, all of it. It's like being the epitome of alchemy or something like that. Like the whole line or the whole lineage, everybody's power or something like that is yours or something like that, okay? Every perspective or something like that. Every seed or something like that. Every consciousness seed. Anyway, Jean, get the two cards. Nine of Swords, okay. Yes, perspective seeds. And again, alchemizing impossibility into possibility. Alchemizing... Hey, sien wat ruik jy my ou? Alchemizing... Again, inertia, the impossibility of telekinesis into the possibility, into the movement of telekinesis of the object. Okay, literally like utilizing thought, literally utilizing energy, frequency, literally utilizing... maybe like nothing in order to create something, literally utilizing you understand what I'm saying, okay? But there's something about like your alchemy is beyond what can be expected, is what I'm hearing, okay? Seven of Wands. Chariot. Okay. There's the Magician as I'm splitting the deck. The Emperor as well. Justice. That's you. Judgment. Jesus. Okay. Like, that's you. Like, I'm going to keep the Magician card out here as well. It's like, go check out the reading I did in my collective. I'm seeing the King and Queen of Cups and the Ten of Swords as well. Okay. And the Ten of Wands. Pile number two, what you need to know about your power, your ability is like, even with lack of power, you manifest power. You alchemize a lack of power into power and authority for you. And not just power and authority, but like emperor. Again, I split the deck on that, but like emperor authority, okay? It's like literally being... But, like, this is what you are at your core, anyway, okay? But, like, it's, like, literally being a piece of nothing, like, a piece of shit nothing or something, and then alchemizing an empire from that, alchemizing godhood from that, alchemizing... You know, like, what? You know... Like, you are the Magician, okay? You are literally the Magician, okay? That's you, pile number two. And that is in regards to Nine of Cups. That's in regards to the Sun. Oh my goodness. That's in regards to alchemy, in regards to spirit things, in regards to fine frequencies, in regards to telekinesis, weather control, fucking apotheosis, my guy. Okay. What? Okay, thank you so much, Paul number two. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting me for a personal reading. Everything is in the description box down below, okay? Also, take the good energy and create more of that consciousness with that. Obviously, you do that because otherwise you wouldn't be the fucking Magician, okay? Bye. Let's see 22-22. Lekker. Satnam, Paul number three. For those of you who picked this spakboom, this is gonna be your reading. To see something about your powers and your abilities. I feel like your power and ability has a lot to do with life. I'm being drawn to the Citrine and also the Sun card. So it has a lot to do with like life. It has a lot to do with freshness. I don't necessarily want to say nature, but nature, of course, because the plant. But like, your power has some kind of freshness to it, okay? There's something about you, maybe like revitalizing. You have some kind of ability of... I just heard misjudgment. You have some kind of ability maybe of like resurrection, okay? Resurrection, I feel like, is your power, pile number three. Is what you're coming into contact and fruition with, okay? Ooh, the devil, yes. Resurrection indeed. Death, resurrection indeed. Okay, so we have the devil. We have the empress. The Ace of Cups. Let's get one more. And the Queen of Cups. I actually thought the Ace of Cups was the Queen of Cups, okay? Judgment. You see the resurrection happening there? People getting out of the coffin. Of course. Ace of Wands with your magic. You just be like, no, you ain't dead, motherfucker. And then they ain't. Right? So let's rearrange these cards the way I want them to. So we have the Empress, we have the Devil. Actually, let's put the Devil just like that. I'm going to leave it just as I put it at the first thing. Because you know what? Death. The Devil, the Empress, Ace of Cups, Queen of Cups. You are resurrection. Pile number three. 22-22. You are resurrection. There's some kind of like... I don't want to say twin flame energy, but there's some kind of maybe even Adam Eve energy, or like, because 22-22, Ace of Cups, the devil with the lovers there. Oh no, there's some kind of like, it doesn't have to do with love. It has something to do with like the very beginnings of like the masculine and the feminine, or something like that. Isis resurrecting Osiris, you know, giving him back his penis. That's what I'm getting here. Your power, power number three, is resurrection. You have the power of Isis, I feel. If you're a man, you have the power of Osiris, I feel. And Osiris is the lord of the underworld, you know? That is you, pile number three. So either way, again, like, that's maybe why I feel this, like, twin flame, like, your masculine, feminine within you, it doesn't matter, is resurrection. It is the died and then rebirthed, God being, okay? Your power is, it's kind of like, I see spakbloom, because spakbloom is that kind of plant. Like, you plant it in degraded areas, it brings back life, it actually creates water on a spiritual, in a spiritual sense, I feel, okay? Like, but very physically, like, energetically. You know how crystals have certain vibrations? This plant creates water. You understand? I feel like that is your power. You bring life. You create life. And not just like this, like existence or like this metaphysical, philosophical thing, but you create actual living, breathing, like, things, okay? Like, it's kind of like your frequency, your energy, and Roman is just confirming this, your frequency, your energy allows resurrection, allows life. It's not like it allows the cycles, but it allows, the cycles are because of you. You understand? Because, like, maybe death was the ultimate enemy or something like that, but, like, because of your resurrection powers, like, it's just another cycle, or it's just, or it's not even a cycle or something. Hey, bravo. You can make good omstamp, Jesus. So that's what I feel like. Your power is resurrection, okay? I feel like I need to squeeze something else out of this energy for you, pile number three, but I feel like that's sufficient. Like it's so quick and it's so like that's just what it is, okay? You are life, pile number three. You are freshness. You are the thing that allows growth. That is your energy. Your consciousness allows growth. And, like, the Empress, of course. Like, that's what the Empress obviously stands for. Like, what? And if you really look at it, perhaps, you know, that's what the devil stands for as well. Again, Osiris, okay? It really depends on how you look at it, okay? I feel like that's sufficient. Thank you so much, Bomber 3. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, and donating, and contacting me for a personal reading. Everything is in the description box down below, okay? You're about to gain some kind of ability, maybe even to, yes, Ten of Swords even, Queen of Wands, yes, to resurrect things. I'm seeing somebody resurrect a bird or something, okay? Or like a dove, again, like, I'm getting some kind of bird, a feminine-ish energy. Doves are, like, feminine energies, okay? But I feel like somebody's about to, like, resurrect something, maybe even, okay? That's your power, pile number three. Boy! Let's do 29. No, let's do 30, okay? Let's do 30 minutes, and then we're just gonna sit and chat. For a moment, we're just gonna sit in silence while I drink a sip of coffee. I'm so hungry. Oh my goodness. I haven't eaten yet. Are we? There we are. No, we're not. A whole minute more. Don't skip, guys. Like, we're, like, really enjoying this energy together, okay? And I feel like it's significant. Like, if you're watching this whole reading or watching this whole part or something, it's significant that we would just be sitting here, as everything always is, right? I feel like there's about to be some kind of break in the matrix or something. There's about to be some kind of, you know, like when COVID, everything stood still. I feel like that's about to happen again, okay? Ooh. That's gonna be fun. But, like, it's gonna be different. Like, the first time around, it was almost like everybody was, like, going through the same thing almost. Not really. Actually, not at all, because what was hidden during the COVID times is being revealed, etc., etc. Now everything is coming to a standstill, on the other way. So if COVID lockdown was really cock for you, like it's about to be very good for you. Okay, pile number four. I just gave some kind of random prediction there, okay? Not a prediction, I just gave a random prophecy there. Like, prediction and prophecy. Like, I just gave some kind of random truth there. Something that's about to befall this planet. Anyway, pile number four, this is your reading. If you pick this beautiful wand, this is going to be your reading to see what are your powers. This... This wand doesn't just remind me of a wand, it actually represents like some kind of high vibrational elven high-tech voodoo doll. Okay, this is actually a voodoo doll of like somebody, right? So interesting. First of all, I feel like you have some kind of ability to, like, you know how people in the spiritual realms, bear with me, people in the spiritual realms like to work with angels and stuff because it's so high vibrational and light. Until you actually meet an angel, they're like super cold because they're so like light and high vibrational. They don't actually give a fuck about you, okay? Like, they truly, truly actually don't. The love you feel is your own love, okay? Trust me on this. Okay, that's what I'm feeling there. But like, so you might actually have some kind of, wow, like Solomon's ring. You might have some kind of control and authority over angelic frequencies. I feel like these might be fallen angels that you actually have control over. It's kind of like your energy plays puppet with their souls, with their eternity or something like that. Interesting. This is kind of giving me this energy. Like, imagine you were like, I don't know, tricked or something like that, and you had to endure some kind of hardship, and then like you died and you woke up in hell, but you were tricked or something, and then waking up in the underworld, you're like, you realize, like, because you were tricked, like your punishment is either not as severe, or like you actually get to go to like the nice part or something, but still have like those that tricked you or those that murdered you as some kind of eternal slave. Like, that's what I'm feeling here. Even though it's so high, like, wow, like the energy is not all love and light, what I'm feeling here for you, pile number four, okay? Like, and if you, yeah, I felt somebody leave because they're like, what the fuck? Yeah, you're not, this is not your reading. Like, somebody here, like, might even seem super like, hello, Rando Porto, but like, they can become really, really, really dark, or they can really utilize light in order to, I don't know, cave in on itself, or take, I don't know what the fuck, Wanger, for you have some kind of voodoo, I'm not saying you have a voodoo doll, but like your energy, like you have control over somebody's soul, some kind of, maybe a magician's soul, maybe an angel's soul, or something like that, okay? Do you understand what I'm saying? I feel like you know exactly what I'm saying, okay? Because you wouldn't have this kind of, like, I don't know, like, I wouldn't be able to read this energy if you didn't know. You understand what I'm saying? Like, you know what's up. Whew. The Tower. Oh my goodness. The Lovers. Ooh. The Chariot. I'm seeing, and the Sun. Ooh. All the way to the Nine of Cups, okay. Portakotakatakatakotakatakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakotakot Paal nummer 4. This is a very spiritual energy. This is very energetic. This is very... There was some kind of... There was maybe two people, let's say, or two beings, or I don't know. There was something, used to be a very intense tower in your life, okay? And maybe there was some kind of energy that maybe kept following you around. It maybe even tried to follow you. I don't really believe in past lifetimes. So maybe like it followed, kept following you lifetime after lifetime, or... from new beginning to new beginning, or like it just kept causing towers in this lifetime for you, or it wanted to follow you into the afterlife or something like that, okay? I feel like after this was exposed to you, like you saw the truth of the situation, like you recognized and realized what exactly was happening. And why you kept going through towers, maybe. Why you kept... there were some kind of like fallen angels or fallen... I'm hearing fallen heroes even. Or fallen something like that that kept attaching to your energy, okay? But since the exposure happened or something, it's reminding me of also a reading I did where like, I think it was a short where I said something about like you recognizing something or you realizing something, you seeing an illusion breaks the illusion, okay? And like, again, so maybe this... realization, this exposure, this recognizing, this real, like, you know, why you kept going through these towers, or why, I don't know what, okay? After this realization, you fully get some kind of control over it. You get to play as if these beings were now, like, your servitors. Was it from Paul number 2 that somebody jumped to Paul number 4, or was it Paul number 1? I can't remember, but maybe go check out Paul number 1, okay? Because it's some kind of full circle energy here, okay? Even. No. So, like, it's kind of like since you endured so many towers, now the tower energy or these beings or these people that caused these towers or something like that for you, now like the tower energy is in your hands. You get to tell the tower what to do. You get to tell these people maybe even what to do, where to go, etc., etc., okay? Something has come very much full circle for you in the best way possible, or is about to. It's kind of like having total control over the thing that kept you in a lack of control or something, okay? Ace of Swords, beautiful. Thank you so much, Collective. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting me for a personal reading. Everything is in the description box down below, and I will see you again for another one. Burn up, burn up, burn up.